and we have the morning session, which involves the first round of the men's Kieran, the fourth discipline in the women's Omnium, and then the first round of repechages in the Kieran as our final discipline. Well, it's delivered high drama and a dominant performance thus far from One Nation. The host nation have won 5 of the 7 medals on offer in the velodrome so far. And so it's been a very fruitful place for Great Britain. They have an opportunity today to add to those with favourites in all 3 disciplines. Well, there's the one man favoured in the Kieran, but he'll have his work cut out still. He's got a long way to go. David Bashir is alongside me, Dave. This is going to be another fascinating battle, and plenty of passion and excitement in the velodrome today.
Yes, good morning, Gerald. It's really looking forward to today. It's the big three final gold medal haul, and Britain a very good chance to take out all 3. But the big men of the Kieran start in the first round. The first 2 go through automatically, and then the rest go to a repechage. Chris Hoy in this field with Watanabe, Van Veldhoven, Sergei Borisov, and the exciting Nishan Phillip in the first round of the men's Kieran. Shane Perkins will race a little bit later on.
Well, this first heat has got all the makings of being pretty interesting itself, with some fairly useful contenders there. Van Veldhoven from New Zealand, 6th in the London World Cup on this venue, the Oceania champion. There he is. He won the Beijing World Cup Kieran event. Peralta, the Spaniard. And there he is. Well, there are a few better than this man at the moment. So Chris Hoy.
They'll draw for positions. Of course, a very tactical affair. Chris Hoy, 4 times world champion, looking to defend his Olympic Kieran crown. There's Van Veldhoven. He gets a position 6. Watanabe's a pretty exciting Kieran rider. This is a hot heat when you look at the fact that Hoy, Watanabe, Van Veldhoven and Phillip in the field. Of course, Hoy and Watanabe made the World Championship final. Hoy won the world title in Melbourne. It's an excellent field. Compare it to the third heat. There's going to be some very good riders missing out.
Yeah, there's some plenty of talent in this field. The Spanish under 23 sprint champion Juan Gasson Peralta. He's also the Kieran champion, 4th in the Beijing World Cup, so he's been in the at the sharp end. Of course, Sir Chris Hoy, we know all about him, a 4-time world champion and the defending Olympic champion, and a legend already in Great Britain. Asian Games sprint champion is Watanabe, but also 3rd in the 5th in the London World Cup. So they've all ridden in the finals in World Cups here. And he's going to line up on the front. So Chris Hoy.
5 Olympic gold medals, 11 World Championship gold, 4 in the Kieran. It's an awesome record. On the outside, Van Veldhoven is a very good young rider from Palmerston North, won the bronze medal in the kilometre time trial in Melbourne, was 3rd across the line in the Kieran final, but relegated to 6th, so a little bit unlucky there. Justin Grace, I should say, his coach, he won the Beijing World Cup, 6th in London, so he's a good up-and-coming young rider. He is the king of the Kieran, Chris Hoy. A brilliant exponent.
Wait for the ovation for this man. I expect great things from him. Missed out on the sprint selection, and Great Britain, David Brailsford, their boss, justified in in the selection of Jason Kenny with his gold medal. Now, this is a very exciting young man, the 21-year-old from Trinidad and Tobago, based in the United States. But he was fourth in the sprint on day five, won the Kieran at the US Grand Prix of Sprinting last year, and sixth in the Pan American Games. Sergei Borisov, second in the Beijing World Cup. 22-year-old Juan Peralta Gascon, fourth in the Beijing World Cup. And there is Kazunari Watanabe, the 28-year-old Asian Games sprint champion. And he was also in that London World Cup. It's almost a rerun of that London World Cup Kieran final on this same track. The Derny will be approaching shortly.
Big men of the Kieran, two to automatically go through. The motor pace will build up in speed and then pull away with 2.5 laps to go. They jostle for position. Philip, who was beaten by Shane Perkins for the bronze medal. So he's not a natural Kieran rider as such. Got great top-end speeds. Still learning the craft in the Kieran. Van Veldhoven moves up on the outside of Watanabe. Chris Hoy just content to ride midfield. And then Peralta, and last of all is the Russian Borisov.
It is, it's a, you said it, Dave, it's a hot first round race, this really is. So you can bet there's going to be some hard racing. Philip, well, we saw him in the match races in the sprint, having qualified 10th, he enjoys the battle of sprinting, but that's a two-up sprint. This is very different. The tactics take a lot of learning. And he's the young man in this field.
Van Veldhoven, will he try to take it out given his kilometre background? Philip has had a lot of racing at these Olympic Games. He's in second wheel. Then Watanabe, who raced very well at the Worlds through the rounds, faded a little bit in the final, but early on he was prominent in the Kieran rounds. So if you look at some of the favourites to go through, Van Veldhoven, Watanabe, Hoy and Philip. Another four riders that stand out. Chris Hoy's got far too much experience to get caught in a bad position, but you really are relying a lot of the time on the other riders' positioning. Four laps to go. Three now with the Derny to pull off, and Veldhoven has a look around the shoulder. Hoy's the first to hook out with Philip. Philip saw Hoy coming, so he moved up very quickly. That's a smart move by the man from Trinidad and Tobago. So Philip leads. Hoy in second place. Van Veldhoven, then Peralta. Chris Hoy puts the foot down. Van Veldhoven moves up. Philip caught on the inside, then Peralta. They get the bell lap. Chris Hoy well positioned. Van Veldhoven, Philip now making ground, but Chris Hoy goes for home down the back straight. Van Veldhoven's going to struggle to make up the ground. Those two will clearly go through. Excellent ride by Chris Hoy. And likewise from the New Zealander Simon Van Veldhoven.
Well, that's how much it means to Chris Hoy, this first round, first step on what he hopes will be a big ladder. And he's smiling as well, Simon Van Veldhoven. A really good performance by him. Philip made the early break. The inexperienced Trinidad and Tobago rider trying something. And just didn't have the sustained top-end speed of these two men, Van Veldhoven and Chris Hoy, who just blasted away from the field, getting themselves into the clear, ensuring that they would go through safely into the next round. The others to the repêchage. Glance over his shoulder. Just making sure he's a winner all the time, Chris Hoy, and gets that under the belt. And he can breathe a sigh of relief and look forward to the next round.
Of course, Jason Kenny winning the sprint title last night. Chris Hoy wins 10.177 for the flying 200. Van Veldhoven, they cleared out to the rest. Peralta, Gascon, Philip Borisov and Watanabe. Very disappointing. They'll go to the repêchage. So it just shows you the crowd get really involved in the Kieran. Hoy and Van Veldhoven, the first automatic qualifiers. Here's the second heat featuring Shane Perkins, Zhang Mao, Max Levy. We've got three former Kieran World Champions in this. Perkins, Levy, and the Dutchman, Tian Morda.
Yeah, he goes back some way, the Dutchman. 2005 World Champion. There he is, the 31-year-old. Still competitive. He was involved in that London race, fourth place in that World Cup. Max Levy. And second at the World Championships. Bronze in the team sprint, of course, in 2008 and at these Olympic Games. 27-year-old Kamil Kaczynski. Went out in the first round in Beijing. And now the 23-year-old, fifth in the Beijing World Cup, and finished 13th in the sprint here. And he's had a busy time, Shane Perkins. And a bronze in the sprint, first Olympic medal.
Six men, two automatic positions, three former world champions. It's a very interesting formula indeed. The Gladiators put the head down before the Durney joins in, and it's underway.
There's a high premium in these first round races. Canelon on the front, the 24-year-old Pan American rider. He was the winner of the Pan American Games in 2011.
Max Levy goes to the front from Germany. Canelon in second place. Perkins third. And they're followed by Kaczynski. He's second last. Mulder last of all, with the Chinese rider Zhang in the middle of the field. It's single file in the field of six. Riders will, in a couple of laps, just try to shuffle their bikes and look for the right wheel. We saw in the previous heat, Philip saw the move coming from Chris Hoy, the defending champion. He was the first to make the move, and then Van Veldhoven raced very intelligently, tracked to Chris Hoy all the way, and they cleared out. Will it be a similar scenario in heat two? More even field.
Yeah. Well, that's an interesting Levy, Perkins, Mulder. Has he still got it in him, the 31-year-old champion of 7 years ago? The Dutchman on the tail end at the moment. Someone is going to miss out here.
Mulder
to do the repechage.
He was disappointing in the World Championships. Missed out in the first round. That's pretty rare for him.
Kaczynski moving up alongside Perkins. Here they go, Perkins is out first. Max Levy reacts well.
So Perkins leads. Levy flicked the wheel. Here's Mulder making the lightning move on the outside, invoking a reaction from Shane Perkins. Levy moves up. Perkins a little bit exposed. It is Tian Mulder from Holland, with Levy moving up strongly. Is that Canyon on the outside from Venezuela? At the moment, Shane Perkins struggling back in the field. Now he gets a wriggle on. But Max Levy, the former world champion of the Kieran, blasts for clear, and he moves ahead and qualifies ahead of Tian Mulder with Canelong. And very disappointing, Shane Perkins may be feeling the effects of yesterday's racing in the individual sprint.
He's made it hard for himself. Yeah, Tian Mulder looks as though he's got it just ahead of Hersini Canelong. Yep, he sees it on the board. It was very tight. It was no contest for the win. Max Levy showing his strength and getting away. And I was going to say that Shane Perkins has done a lot here. He's been in the team sprint and the sprint. And probably feeling the effects of that now. This is the battle for second, and Hersenie Canelon just edged out by the Dutchman, and that'll be a relief to him. He doesn't have to go through the repêchage. Well, that's how tight it was. So there's Max Levy, no issues at all for the former world champion.
He won bronze in the team sprint, did not compete in the individual event, so he's fresh legs, and he's won impressively. Tian Morta, the other automatic qualifier, the rest of the field into the repêchage, first round of the men's Kieran.
The repêchage round takes place after the women's omnium individual pursuit discipline, which follows this heat. Only one rider per nation in the sprint events, which ensured that Great Britain had to make an interesting selection for their sprint, and Jason Kenny went for the sprint, and Chris Hoy in this.
Here's Christos Volokakis, 2005 World Junior Kieran champion. Interesting rider, third at the Worlds to Chris Hoy at senior level. There is Awang from Malaysia. He's won the Kieran series in 2009. And second in the world, Kieran, to Chris Hoy in 2010. Joseph Veloce of Canada, 2011 national Kieran champion. There's Puerto Zapata of Colombia, Pan American champion in Argentina this year.
And the speaker from the Czech Republic, the national champion, third in the Cali World Cup, bronze in the junior and under 23 world championships. Mikhail Bourguin, the 32-year-old Frenchman, about whom there was some controversy. France, in order to get him into the Kieran, entered him in the road race because they'd filled their quota of track riders, and he did 3Ks the road race and dropped out. He had the humility to apologize to his teammates and to the greater road race field. Not to all the road racers were particularly enamored with that move by the French selectors.
This is a very, very even field. Mikhail Bourguin stands out fourth in the World Championship final. If Awang has his Kieran legs on, he's a very good Kieran racer. Second from the outside from Malaysia, who's looking for the Durney, and he gets it. In second place, Volokakis. You never quite know what to expect with a Greek rider. Unpredictable competitor, but very rapid on his day. And Veloce, young Canadian, on the way up. So you would expect that Bourguin and Awang would be favoured to go through automatically in this heat, but as we've seen, doesn't go all according to plan in the Kieran.
Yeah. Volokakis just rode the qualification, the sprints, and then bailed. Awang was eighth in the sprints, second in the Asian Championships behind Isai Ngun Om Lam, fifth in Cali. Eight of nine children is Azizul Hasni of Awang, and the Malaysian on the frontier. He might have tired legs. You can bet Bourguin hasn't. This is his sole event, and there he is. All sole event other than 3 kilometers of the road race.
Aziz Alhasni Awang looks up to the big screen and leads from Volokakis. At third wheel is Puerto Zapata from Colombia, then Bourguin, speaker, and last of all the Canadian Joseph Veloce. They'll begin to warm up. The Durney will pull off at this point in the next lap. You can see the riders beginning to get nervous, twitching, looking over the shoulder.
Who's going to make the first move? And the carcass is holding back. Awang is on the front and will go alone up front. A slow reaction.
Well, he's got a big break here. He's not a front runner normally. Remember, it's so important to avoid the rapid charger. Wang exposed. Two laps to go. The first to make the move, Bourgain. Speaker on his wheel. And then Puerto Zapata, the Colombian, awkwardly placed. Bourgain goes for home in the final lap. Out of the seat is Speaker. Wang getting a second wind. Good ride by the Malaysian. They're followed by Puerto Zapata, who's getting up on the inside. Bourgain looks comfortable. And he wins just. Very tight go. Wang was second. He's got through, so it's Bourgain and Wang, the automatic qualifiers, with Puerto Zapata just missing out.
Well, as you said, it's really important to avoid the repêchage to come back. Well, the gold medal being decided today, it just saps the energy, and Mikhail Bourgain and Azizul Hasni Wang doing a great job. Wang did come back strongly. He was on the front, went out early, and then Bourgain and Speaker set off in pursuit. Speaker lost ground whilst Bourgain just took control, and Wang came back strongly. Chased hard by Zapata. So the first two go through. And it's Bourgain and Wang. Zapata will have to come back in an hour and do the repêchage. Mikhail Bourgain has obviously set out his stall to really go well in the Kieran, and he started impressively. Top two go through. The rest will have to keep warm for a little while longer. The second round of the men's Kieran is in the second session on this final day at the track. So Bourgain, Hoy, Levy, Wang, Mulder and Van Veldhoven through to that second round. And these are the riders who will go through the first round repêchage. Perkins, the Australian, Velocic from Canada, Zhang Miao from China, Zapata as well. Watanabe, Kuzinski, Borisov, Philip Canelon, and Volikakis, the Greek rider.
There's the point standings in the women's Omnium after three of six races. Saw some exciting racing yesterday. Laura Trott on the same point score as Sarah Hammer. And there's the list further down, going to Chiao of Chinese Taipei. So it's Trott, Hammer, Edmondson and Witten, the four favourites, Gerald, have occupying the top four spots, and I think that's where the medals are going to come from.
Yeah, you can't look too far beyond those. Laura Trott's won two of the disciplines, the elimination and the flying lap, and she is in great position. Though Sarah Hammer, Edmondson and Witten. There's a way to go though, and we've got three events still to get through today, but you've got to feel that those three, those four, are very much in the mix here for the medal. Angie Gonzalez. First in the time trial. On the side of the track. Lei Yuqiao.
Silence been called for, and the riders steel themselves for the task ahead. Very similar at the world titles, these two riders. Xiao from Chinese Taipei, 3:48.701, had her placed in 19th position, and the Venezuelan Gonzalez Garcia, 3:48.501, so not their best disciplines,
Gonzalez 17th in the flying lap, 9th in the points, went quite impressively there, and 18th in the elimination.
In fact, this is Zhao's worst event. She was top 10 in the elimination in Melbourne, scratch race, and finished third in the time trial. So she's more suited to the sharper events.
Yeah, she went 17th in both the points in the elimination, 11th in the flying lap. Gonzalez 15th at the Worlds overall.
She's going very strongly. She's got a nice break over Gonzalez. Remember, it's about time and maintaining the form over 3 kilometres. You know, she's got a more rapid start. Can she keep it going in the second kilometre? Xiao of Chinese Taipei.
She's going well, Xiao. Nearly a second up on Gonzalez, who's starting to wind it up now and try and pull it back a little bit. And this is when it starts burning the muscles. First event of three today. They had three events yesterday. It's about how they recovered. Digging really deep now is Gonzalez. A glance across the track. She'll see that she's leaking time all the while to Xiao from Chinese Taipei. A second and a half down on the rider from Chinese Taipei is Gonzalez as they come to the last 7:50.
And she's on a schedule for a pretty good ride here, Xiao. Around about 3:46, 3:47 if she maintains the schedule. At the moment, she's opening up the margin on her opponent. Looking very strong. So maybe an improvement since Melbourne. Working on the speed endurance. Beginning to show signs of real fatigue, though. She's got the bell lap. It's been a pretty good ride, going for a personal best. She finished midfield in the Omnium in 10th place. But she's going to improve her time from Melbourne and stop the clock at 3:49. Just outside of time, in fact, from Melbourne, 3:48.701. So she must have faded in the last 500 metres quite badly because she was up on the schedule. 3:54.926 from Gonzalez.
Yeah, she will be disappointed. She went 3:48.501 at Melbourne. So the Venezuelan, very disappointed with that performance. Glance across the track. The coach is continually giving splits and keeping the riders motivated. As you can see towards the end here, Xiao fatiguing. Chung Lee and Maria Luisa Calle-Williams from Colombia. The next two riders in the women's Omnium. Chung Lee, the Chinese, was ninth in the flying lap. 15th in the points and 16th in the elimination. Well, she's 43 years old, is Maria Luisa Calle-Williams. Still competing at the highest level, amazing. Reception for the next two riders on the track in the women's Omnium, the individual pursuit, the time trial at least, over 3,000 metres. And the Colombian didn't go too well in the World Championships, finishing 23rd. But she did get a bronze medal at the Olympics in Athens in 2004, which at the time was Colombia's first cycling medal. Hello Williams, but she went on a bit of an issue because she tested positive and had to return the medal, but the test proved to be incorrect and the medal was subsequently returned to her. As the Pan American Games individual time trial champion 2011, and won the pursuit of the Pan American Championships earlier this year. So, a pretty useful pedigree. She's down by nearly a second and a half after the first split at 1,000 meters is the Colombian. Yi Shuang from China is the Asian champion in the Omnium. We're looking to go around 3:38. If she does that, she'll be well pleased, but might take some doing, because that put her in eighth place in the race in the World Champs. There's not much between them now. Kelly Williams has found her rhythm and is coming back well. A lot of movement on the bike from Zhang Li. And the Colombian has now gone ahead. So she's turned around this race after a rather sluggish first thousand. The next thousand seen her take nearly 2 seconds out of the time pursuing Chinese Taipei's Xiao's time at 3:49.051 as the leader at the moment.
So Huang of China and Kelly Williams. Huang really struggling at this stage. Kelly Williams showing her experience, measuring her performance. As expected, she was poor in the flying 250, but she's come to life in the individual pursuit. Left the Chinese rider in her wake.
These two riders currently 15th and 16th in the 18 rider field. And Kelly Williams is rocketing ahead now. Well done. She's clocked 3:40, 3:49, which puts her at the top of the pile after those four riders. And Huang Li, 3:45, 6:10, puts her second. And the Omnium. Each discipline, the winners of each discipline is rewarded with 1 point all the way down to the last place. 18 riders in this field. Just a clip of the foam from Kelly Williams there. indication that she was getting a little fatigued.
Six disciplines and a gold medal up for grabs, and this is an important step. Clara Sanchez against Li Minhui. Sanchez making that transition from being a Kieran rider to doing the multi-event discipline, the Kieran. The Frenchwoman was second quickest in the flying 200, 14.058. She was then last in the point score, an event she wasn't expected to be prominent at, and 13th in the elimination, so one of the earlier riders out in the elimination. Ground to make up for Clara Sanchez. ...2004 and 2005 World Kieran Champion. There's Li Minhui. Eighth in the Olympic Games points race, 2010 Asian Games champion in the individual time trial. Li was 14th in the flying 250, 14th in the points. And 11th in the elimination.
Clara Sanchez has started very well. She's gone out seemingly much the faster of the two, settled into the tuck position very quickly. And already going well.
Lee's a 3:49 rider from the World Championships. Sanchez did not compete at the world title, so it's a huge step for her to make the transition from the sprint ranks to the endurance event.
It's very smooth at the moment as Li. Minimal movement of the upper body. And Sanchez is leaking time. Going to really have to manage her output in this grueling event. So through 1,000, Li is nearly 4 seconds down on Kelly Williams's time. And Sanchez is nearly 7.5 seconds down at this stage after 1,000. But we saw how Kelly Williams came back so well after being down in that first 1,000 meters in her ride. Well, Sanchez is going to be closed down very soon. The flying leap.
It's totally different discipline, isn't it, riding the time trial bike, and the type of skills she needs to refine at the top level, Clara Sanchez. The speed endurance takes its toll on the body, and none more so than the Omnium.
I have a feeling it's an event that takes a long time for riders to perfect. You've got to manage all your efforts throughout six events over 2 days. And obviously capitalize on your strengths and your weaknesses. Must be improved, but also minimize the losses on those. This is a fine ride by Li.
She can maintain the schedule. She's in for a time of under 3:50, but she's gone out hard to round Sanchez and catch her, urged on by the crowd. Whether the Korean can just maintain this momentum 500 metres left to go. That would be so disheartening for Clara Sanchez, who's been a dual world champion in the Kieran, and Lee is suffering at the moment. Suffering big time.
Through the finish goes Lee, 3:46.871 puts her in third place. And Sanchez finishes nearly 10 seconds further back in 3:56. So she's 16 seconds down on Kelly Williams's time. Definitely not her strength. The French rider.
The form of Lee from Korea. Next up we have Joe Kuzanowski of New Zealand against Oliveira of Spain. Bike set up in the starting gate. Kuzanowski was 16th in the flying lap, 14.924. She was an active rider on the point score, finished seventh. One of the riders to take a lap. And then also seventh in the elimination. ...33-year-old from Christchurch divides her time between Christchurch and Colorado Springs. Lea Oliveira, the 35-year-old from the Basque region of Spain, won the bronze medal in the women's point score at the 2008 Games in Beijing, behind Marianne Vos and Joanca Gonzalez. So it's a match against the clock. Kelly Williams has set the marker down at 3:43.49. Kuzanowski was 16th in the individual pursuit in Melbourne, 3:43.594. And Oliveira from Spain, a lot better, 3:38.938. So she's a specialist in the individual time trial. Overall, she finished 8th. Place below Kuzanowski, so they were very, very even in the final standings of the World Championships in Melbourne.
But you'll really want to make this count, an opportunity to make up some ground on the overall standings.
Well, Liberia is 12th currently. Kuzanowski 11th, just a point separating them, 30 and 31 points respectively. And of course, the leaders are on 12 points.
Four at the moment in the prime positions, the Laura Trott and Sarah Hammer on 12 points, and Ed Edmondson on 17 and Tara Whitten on 18. Remember, a 1 point to win a discipline through the 1,000-metre mark, and Kuzanowski's on a really good ride at the moment. She's well on course to go ahead of Kelly Williams. Oliveira down by 2.7 seconds. And Kuzanowski on track at the moment to lead it. She really is hammering it out here, is the New Zealander. Potential at Around sub 342, 343 would be a good response from Joanne Kizanowski.
Very aggressive ride by Kizanowski given her performance at the Worlds. Of course, a very, very good all-round cyclist. 17th in the road race in Athens, 28th in Beijing, 8th in the world titles in Barassi on the road, 6th in the points race at the Worlds on the track in 2005. She's ridden professionally since 05 and in America a lot of the times doing her racing.
Yeah, she's based with an American team for the last 3 years and based in Colorado Springs, so a great area to hone her skills, and she's going really well now. 7:50 to go. She's well on course to beat the time of Keller Williams at 3:40, 3:49. Be an improvement on her time at the Worlds if she were to go under that of nearly 3 seconds, if she were to go under 3:40. And the Spaniard, she is showing signs of fatigue. It may well not even make 3:43, and she went 3:38 at the Worlds. The bell for the two now. Kizanowski putting everything out there, the New Zealander, in the time trial. Third event of the Omnium, and she clocks 3:44.971. Just lost a little time over the last 1,000 to be in second place. 3:44.971, which is just outside her time by a second and a half almost, her time at the World Championships. And Oliveira, 3:46.317. Quite considerably outside of time at the Worlds, and 5.9 seconds down on the lead time at the moment. Maria Luisa Keller Williams of Colombia. Her time is standing up well at 3:43.49.
She left absolutely nothing on the track. The Kiwi putting every effort in. Of course, the morning times are not as quick as the afternoon session, and it's been one of the coolest days for a couple of weeks in London. So to get that temperature of 28 degrees and fast times, it's probably not at that mark yet in the Olympic Velodrome.
We move down to the closer to the sharp end of the standings. Coming out onto the track, our next pair of riders, Marlies Meyers-Garcia of Cuba and Tatiana Sharapova of Belarus, who was so impressive in the points race. Garcia's best discipline though so far is the flying lap. She's eighth in that. Sharapova from Belarus, second in the points, 12th in the flying lap, and 15th in the elimination. The next two riders halfway down the list of the Omnium competitors. This is Marlies Meyers-Garcia of Cuba and Tatiana Sharapova of Belarus.
Sharapova, 3:37.528 at the Worlds. And the Cuban, 3:42.593. So the Belarusian well capable of going under 3:40. But whether she can do it today in these conditions, we'll soon find out. It's Garcia, who's gone out hardest.
Yeah, I think they're probably all setting their sights a little lower in terms of the marks they set at the World Championships in April in Melbourne. Oh, they backed up after the first three events on the first day. Not much to choose between the two just at the moment. Garcia's gone out at a cracking pace. 1:14, 1:25 for her first 1,000. Which puts her as the fastest over the first 1,000 so far.
Sharapova, bronze medalist of the points race in the World Championships in Denmark, eighth in the Omnium. Points race, multiple points race champion and time trial champion Belarus. Second of the European Omnium Championships, 2010, 11 and 12. So she's a good all-round cyclist at 28 years of age, coming into her peak.
And she's putting the hammer down now is the Belarus rider. Through she goes, comfortably clear of Garcia. And by the 2,000 meter time speed, I think she'll be well ahead of Garcia and quite possibly in line to beat the time. 2:25, 1:48. Well, she's on schedule to go at around 3:38, 3:39 here is Sharapova. It should put her at the top of the pile. Looking very solid, but it's this last 750-500 that really takes the toll. And we've seen riders losing a good second and a half. There's Garcia, bends to the task here, digging so deep to try and put in her best efforts over the last lap of this race. Has been impressive from Sharapova. She got the legs to get home and post the fastest time. Yes, 3:38, 3:01. And we have a new leader with Garcia. 3:41, 8:97 puts her in third place. Good ride by the Cuban as well. So Tatiana Sharapova, the first sub 3:40 time posted. Tatiana Sharapova, 28-year-old from Belarus. Fifth in the 2011 World Championships, 13th this year in the Omnium. And as Dave was saying, a points race world champion. She's a national champion in virtually everything on the track in Belarus. Sprint, team pursuit, scratch and points. And was a European silver medalist in the Omnium last year. So I wonder if she's putting in a very good performance here in the individual pursuit.
Kirsten Wild and Evgenia Romanuto next up in heat six of the individual pursuit, event four in the women's Omnium. There's the 29-year-old professional rider for the Drink Leontine team. She should be pretty handy at this event. She won a prologue stage of the Giro d'Italia in 2009, won two stages during that Giro. National point score champion in 2011. Third in the World Championships in Melbourne in the Omnium. Very good all-round cyclist. And there's Romagnuto, European point score champion last year, World Cup Omnium winner in Kazakhstan, sixth at the world titles in Melbourne, just 24 years of age, so on the rise as an Omnium rider.
Way they roll. Kirsten Viet, the strong Dutch riders, won six races on the road for pro team. Adrink Leontien, the Dutch based pro team, including a couple of stages of the Tour of Qatar early in the year. She was fourth in the flying lap, fifth in the elimination, and 16th in the points, all of which puts Kirsten Wild in seventh place, one ahead of Evgenia Romagnuta, who went well in the elimination and the points, fourth and sixth in those two events, but then was 15th in the flying lap. So this is a test. But she started out well, Romagnuta. 3:38.301 the time to beat, and at 1,000 metres, 1:14.162.
She was fifth, the Russian at the World Championships in this event, 3:36.049. So well under 3:40 time. She keeps that schedule going early on. She's going to be in for a very competitive time here.
She's posted a pretty competitive first thousand at 1:14.647. Kirsten Wild a little bit outside of that at 1:16. The middle thousand into the rhythm, and the last thousand really takes huge energy and digs deep into the training that has been put in over the months leading into the Olympic Games.
Kirsten Wild coming back strongly. We know she's got that road grounding, road background. We'll get an indication of how they're faring through 2 kilometres. So that's on a schedule of around about 3:40 for both riders. If they can maintain that pace, they're really beginning to struggle and fatigue in the last kilometre.
Put in a big effort in that middle section of 1,000, Kirsten Wild.
Romagnuto's hurting after starting this 3 kilometre event impressively. She's fallen well behind the Dutch woman.
Well, the Russian was 13th at the London World Cup. Did win the World Cups in Beijing and Astana in Kazakhstan, but the London World Cup was perhaps a better barometer, because most of the top riders who were involved in this Olympic discipline were there in the Omnium. So the bell lap, here they go. Real effort from Kirsten Wild, body rolling all over the bike as she puts in every last effort, clips the foam as she goes over in 3:39.741 for the second fastest time. So just under 3:40. It's a really good effort by Kirsten Wild.
Romagnuto in fifth place, 3:42.301. Tough conditions for the riders. Tough to get the gearing right too. After a slow start to the 3 kilometre event, Kirsten Wild has come home strongly to post the second quickest time presently.
Evgenia Romagnuta, 3:42.301. She was eighth going into this event on the overall Omnium standings. The last two events in the second session on the final day of track will be the scratch race and the time trial, after which the gold medal will be decided. So they'll have a few hours to recover, warm down and then recover. Now these are the two riders, fifth and sixth in the overall standings on the Omnium at the moment. Julien De Heur from Belgium. Malgorzata Wojtra from Poland. So many athletes at these games, fingernails painted in the colours of the national flag. Well, she won the points race, did Wojtra.
It was a brave ride in the points race by the young rider from Poland. In contrast to her opponent here on the track, but really they're racing against the clock. She was fourth in the points, 10th in the flying lap, and 6th in the elimination, so pretty consistent away from her point score standing. Wojtra was 13th in the flying lap, and she really did suffer 10th in the elimination after that superb performance, helped in part by Lee, because when she tried to stay away, which she did for the final few laps, Lee did help her, which was a very tidy 5 point gain late in the point score.
But an example of how brutal this Omnium can be. She really put herself out there in the points race. Clearly a strength of hers, and then suffered in the elimination, which was next to come. And that's all about managing your efforts over the entire 6 events. And the Belgian going impressively here.
On a useful schedule. National sprint champion as a 16-year-old, Julien De Heur, and then a few years later she looked to the road and was a world junior road champion in Cape Town. So certainly a versatile cyclist. Wojtra still only young at 22, both 22 years of age. She was the Omnium champion of Europe in under 23 ranks last year.
And went on to finish fourth at the World Champ, so clearly one for the future. Third in the World Cup in Beijing and seventh at the Cali World Cup. The 4 World Cup rounds starting late last year and finishing up in London in February.
But the Her was top 10 of the world titles in ninth place, and she's taken a pretty commanding lead over Wojtra. She's maybe showing the effects of some fatigue. That 2,000 kilometer split, 2:27 has her on about 3:40 pace. She's showing no signs of stress at this point. 500 meters to go, both the very young riders in Omnium terms. Wojtra just showing the tension in the neck and the helmet rolling around the shoulders. The bike flicking around the place. De Heur a lot more composed. She gets the bell lap. The time to beat, 3:38.301. She's not going to be under that, but she's looking to get under 3:40. Straining every sinew. Trying to get everything out of the body. The fourth event in 6 and 3:41, 4:95. So plenty of the cyclists have faded in the last of 500 metres, and we saw it there once more. Maybe it's a gearing situation, that the atmosphere a little bit more heavy in the morning session. Voitra 3:45.083.
Yes, Dave was saying it is a cooler day today around the Olympic precinct, and although the temperature is regulated to around 28 degrees inside the velodrome, we try and also maintain the atmospheric pressure at around 1,010 millibars. But conditions do change. It's also to do with how the athletes back up after the first 3 days, or first three events on day one, come back on day two, have a good rest and recovery. Have they hit the track in the morning session fresh and with the right mindset? Grueling event, the Omnium. Right, we get down to the business end of the competitors in the Omnium here. The positions 3 and 4 in the overall standings, Edmondson and Witten. She's a real talent, is young Annette Edmondson from South Australia. Silver medalist at the World Championships. Capable of posting anything close to 3:32, 3:33. I don't think that'll happen here. But
Tara Witten, a very rapid individual pursuitist. 3:30.011 at the world titles. It was largely the event that kept her in the medal hunt. She finished fourth overall. Laura Trott, of course, the world champion. And Tara Witten was seventh in the flying lap. Third in the point score, and eighth in the Omnium. Very consistent. Currently in fourth place, Annette Edmondson was quick, as you would expect, in the flying lap. In third place, 14.261. Off the pace in the point score, 11th. And she was third in the elimination, so that was a good performance. And early on, the sprinter turned distance rider Edmondson has gone out pretty impressively.
Tara Witten, the 32-year-old, very experienced. Just missed out on the medal at the World, finishing in fourth. And if anything, she can go even faster. Has a time of the Worlds of 3:30. They'll get a split shortly. Well, Edmondson is on schedule to go a lot faster than Sharikova if she maintains this. Likewise, Witten.
Tara Witten put in an excellent lap. She's pulled back the margin. Edmondson, the Australians, finished just outside the medals in the team's pursuit when they were favoured to face Great Britain in the final. They missed out altogether. So Annette Edmondson under pressure now. Tara Witten has turned on the afterburners. And we'll see the 2 kilometre split. I think it's going to be well under 2:24. If that's the case, we're looking for a rapid time.
Edmondson, of course, a two-time world champion, and so she knows how to get the best out of her body and her bike over the 2 days and six disciplines of the Omnium. Bigger button, Witten. Edmondson still at the age of 20, well, showing remarkable form, but look at Witten now. She's blasting around.
That's 2:21 pace. a second outside her split at the World Championships when she recorded 3:30. So she is really managing the situation well to this point, Tara Whitten.
Edmondson really has to just manage herself as well here, not to get too distracted by what Whitten's doing and to focus on her time. She's leaking big time, it seems. Down in second at the moment overall, that is. Whitten is putting in a huge effort.
And this could be a medal-winning ride by Tara Whitten of Canada. Remember, she missed out on the podium at the World Championships. She's got to go under Sharikova's time of 3:38, but how far? Edmondson's struggling to her normal level. Here's Tara Whitten trying to get the most out of the bike in the lunge to the line, and she stops the clock at 3:31.114. That's an outstanding ride in these conditions. 3:35 for Annette Edmondson. And that's just superb by the Canadian.
Fantastic. I mean, she was just over 7 seconds faster than the previous best of Sharikova, and 4.8 seconds quicker than Annette Edmondson, who's posted the second fastest time. But Tara Whitten has laid down the gauntlet there. Don't discount the former world champion in this Omnium at London 2012. A vast experience of the Canadian. Against the strength and vitality of the 20-year-old Australian, and also, of course, Laura Trott, who's next up in our final heat. Another one involving either end of the experience and age spectrum. Trott at 19, nearly 20, and Sarah Hummer at 29.
Will Laura Trott be part of a triple gold feast for Great Britain to finish off these track championships? There she is, the gold medal winner in the team's pursuit, world record holder. They were joking in the British press, if cycling were a country at the Olympic Games, they'd be in 10th place.
Well, they took 12 medals at Beijing, all told. Get the look on the face of Sarah Hammer there. Huge effort and concentration as they set off now. The last heat in the women's 3 kilometer individual pursuit in the Omnium. Fourth of six disciplines. The time to beat over 3,000 meters, 3:31.114. But we'll look at the first 1,000 meter split, which the fastest so far has been Annette Edmondson of 1:13.652, although she faded a little bit in the next 2,000 to finish second to Tara Whitten at this stage. The Hammer really is going out very, very strongly indeed. 3:31.651 in the event, finished second to Laura Trott, to Tara Whitten at least, at the World Championships. Laura Trott, 3:31.789, was third in this discipline at the World Championships in the Omnium.
Laura Trott trying to keep her composure. Great support in the velodrome. Sarah Hammer, a four times individual pursuit world champion. That's her pedigree. She virtually lifted the United States to the bronze medal.
And Hammer is on course to go well beyond Tara Whitten's time, should she maintain this momentum. And she's going very well. 1:12.272 through 1,000 metres. That's nearly a second and a half up on Tara Whitten's time and that of Edmondson.
Hammer got the USA into the final of the team's pursuit largely to her massive turns out in front. And she's putting the hammer down. 112 each through 1 kilometre. So we're looking at times of around about 3:30 if they can maintain this pace. This is excellent pursuit riding. Huge pressure, and a result here could be the difference between gold and silver. That's how crucial it is.
And how tight it is, yes, at the top of the overall leaderboard. These are the top two riders, 12 points each so far after three events of the Omnium. And Hammer looks as though she's going to post the time and sneak ahead. Perhaps a less... Laura Trott can put in a monster last thousand. She's down by a second.
Well, Sarah Hammer's shown the ability consistently in her career to turn it up in laps and really take a lot out of her opponents, and that's what she's doing here. She's putting the hammer down literally by name and nature. Oh, this is a brilliant ride by Sarah Hammer. 2:21 through 2K, and that's on a pace for around about 3:31. Question is, can she maintain it? The adrenaline surging. Will Laura Trott fight back? They get the bell lap. Hammer well in front. It's going to be quick. Will it? Whether it's under 3:31, let's see. Sarah Hammer trying to get the most out of her bike. 3:31, 1:14 the time to beat by Tara Whitten. Laura Trott behind her. Hammer stops the clock at 3:29.554. Wow. That is a superb ride, under 3:30. No wonder she's smiling.
Isn't that an impressive ride? Massively impressive, because she's gone faster than Tara Whitten went at the World Champs. She's gone faster than Tara Whitten went here, and even faster than Laura Trott, who's second in the individual pursuit at 3:30.547. But Sarah Hammer, the only rider under 3:30, 3:30.554. That is a huge, huge ride. She has now put her name very definitely in the hat there for the gold medal, with two events still to come. Hammer, Trott, Whitten, Edmondson, in that order in the individual pursuit. Scratch race and time trial still to come in the evening session here at the Velodrome. And that is going to be such drama, because we've only got overall just 1 point between Sarah Hammer and Laura Trott after four events. Hammer on 13, Trott on 14, Whitten and Edmondson on 21 apiece, and they'll be battling it out as well.
You look at the form, Laura Trott, an excellent 500 time trial rider. Sarah Hammer a little bit better in the scratch race normally, but that can change. Scratch race is a very funny race if riders get laps. So one thing's for sure, we're ready for an exciting finish to the women's Omnium, and that could have put her into the gold medal seat. Sarah Hammer, sub 3:30 ride at the moment. She leads Laura Trott, and they've cleared out from Tara Whitten and Annette Edmondson. So we're looking at gold and silver at the moment, either Sarah Hammer or Laura Trott. The British fans hope it'll be the latter. Only one British rider so far has won dual gold medals, and that's Jason Kenny. Laura Trott trying to join that category today with Sir Chris Hoy and Victoria Pendleton.
Pendleton, yes, still to come. Well, this is the overall standings, just a point at the top between those top two. Clara Sanchez lost a lot of ground with a rather disappointing pursuit. The Frenchwoman slipping right down. So the individual pursuit of the Omnium done. They've done four events. They've got time to recuperate and recover for a tough evening on the track with those two events, the scratch race and the time trial. The Gladiators preparing for the first round of repechage in the men's Kieran. Again, six riders in each race, two races. Chris Hoy and Simon van Veldhoven among those six riders to go directly through to the next round. Veloci, Zhang, Peralta, Gascon, Polakakis, Borisov, and Philip. The riders in this first repechage round of the Kirin.
And this is when it can get rough. First three riders progress to the second round, but more evenly matched to Kirin riders here. There's Nishan Phillips. Just wonder whether his emotional and physical toil in getting to that bronze medal ride in the individual sprint has taken its toll. He's only a young man, just 21.
Sergei Borisov, the big Russian, and Joseph Veloce from Canada. Well, this is the real rough and tumble now, because a chance for one of only three riders of the six to go through to the second round and keep their hopes alive.
So from the outside we have Philip of Trinidad and Tobago. The riders roll up. And Zhang of China. There's Philip, Pan-American record holder and champion. 9.775 rider in the Flying 200. Made so many improvements in 2011 and 12 under Jamie Staff. His personal coach is the US track coach. And we know the sprinters in track and field, but this guy is a rapid man on the bike. Zhang Mao of China. Volokakis, a former world junior champion from Greece, was poor in the heats. Borisov of Russia has been there and thereabouts at European level. Joseph Veloce, second at the Pan American titles this year. And Juan Peralta Gascon. So three to go through. It's the ride that provides so much entertainment in a lot of ways, that the repercharge.
Get the feeling Philip relishes this battle to get into the next round. Here comes the Derny, as it's called. And away they go. And immediately it's Peralta onto the front, tucking in behind the Derny. Greek rider Volokakis behind him. And it's Zhang Miao, Veloci, Borisov, and Philip, who is right on the front in the first round.
So single file, and the riders just look up to the big screen and just check whether it remains in that formation. Peralta Gascon leading out.
Derny increasing in speed all the while, up to 50 kilometers an hour. It'll break away with 2.5 laps to go, and the race will be on. Soon enough, the riders will start looking around and getting an idea of who is starting to make a twitch.
The hum of the motor pace increases, and as does the tension and anticipation for the riders.
And the carcass keeping an eye behind him. Zhang Miao. Borisov moving up on the outside. Here's Volokakis, and he's going to go first. Borisov on the outside. The Spaniard is tucked in there. Borisov goes.
So it's a Zhang on the outside who moves up. Volokarkas. There's Borisov. Peralta, Gascon. A lap and a half out. And the Chinese rider trying to back them up and then kick for home, which he does. It's Volokarkas, the first to challenge, and Peralta Gascon on the outside. They're followed by Veloce, who's trying to find an inside run. Zhang leads the inside. Volokarkas comes quickly, and Volokarkas wins. Maybe Peralta Gascon second, and I think Zhang's got third. Very tight go, but he was well positioned. That was the key for Christos Volokarkas, the former junior world champion. He was in a good position, a lap out, to strike, and he did.
Very close for second and third. The battle, of course, because the first three go through to the second round. So Volokarkas takes it. Gascon and Zheng Mao have been credited with finishing second and third. They will go through. Philip Veloce and Borisov miss out. Philip had an enormous amount of work to do coming on the outside, as did Gascon, who did extremely well to get over the top of Veloce. Gascon did well in taking second, just ahead of Zhang Miao, with Philip dipping too late to take third place and finishing in fourth.
So the qualifiers, Volokarkas, Peralta Gascon, and Zhang Miao, with Philip edged out of the repechage. Christos Volokarkas gives hope to fans of Greek cycling.
Second heat of the repechage round. Shane Perkins, Puerta.
Puerta's a part of the Colombian Pan American champion this year.
Canelon from Venezuela. 25-year-old, fifth in the Pan American Championships. Shane Perkins, well, he's done so much riding and racing in these Olympic Games. Has he still got it in him to finish inside the top three here? Asian Games sprint champion Watanabe. Czech Republic, 23-year-old. He's the national champion. From a bronze medalist junior and under 23 World Championships. In this event, Krasinski went out in the first round in 2008. He's in the repechage here, so gotta go a little bit better than that and get through. And the last man, that Canelon of Venezuela.
So it's Canelon on the outside from Venezuela, straight to the front from Speaker. And the Colombian is a very good rider. Puerto Zapata won an exciting Pan American title in Argentina this year. Then Perkins, Krasinski, and last of all, Watanabe, who was very disappointing in the first round, finishing last in his heat. Remember, he made the final in Melbourne. So he and Perkins were the big shocks from the first round of racing. They've had to come to the repechage. Let's see if they can move through from this point. The top three go through.
Canelon on the front, Speaker. And then Puerta Zapata, Perkins, and Paul Krasinski. And on the back is Watanabe.
Shane Perkins, former Kieran World Champion a few years back now. Missed out on the medal in the team sprint. One bronze in the individual. He's riding at fourth wheel as the pace picks up, and Canelon has a good look at the big screen. That's what the Riders will do, just to decrease the tension. They'll use the screen to judge where their opponents are at, calculate their tactics when the Durney pulls off. Calculation at around 55, 60 kilometres an hour. It's a tough ask, but that's what the Riders are there to do. The rapid men on the boards, these Kieran Riders.
They start looking over their shoulders, those up the field. Here's the move.
The first from Speaker from the Czech Republic. Catalong reacts. They're 1-2 at the moment. And they're followed in third place by Puerto Zapata. Here's moving up on the inside and almost a crash there. Shane Perkins. Watanabe made the rapid move. Perkins trying to thread his way through. So Watanabe moves up the Speaker, a lap out. Here's Shane Perkins emerging strongly. There's Catalong as well. It's Watanabe there from Catalong. From Venezuela, they're moving up really quickly. Here's Kosinski sneaking up. It's a Watanabe leading, and Catalong gets there. Very close for third between Kosinski and Shane Perkins, who rode a poor tactical race. But it's the Venezuelan Hersteny Canayong who gets there in a very, very tight contest.
So tight, and it is Watanabe, Canelon, and Perkins just gets it. The third spot to qualify for the next round, but he left it very, very late. Got himself into all sorts of trouble. And had to do a lot of work over the last 60, 70 metres. Kizunari Watanabe, the Japanese rider on the inside, just getting it, and look how tight it is between Perkins and Kuczynski, the pole. It's tight enough up front. Well, then you separate them. Perkins, oof, just ahead. But by a minuscule amount, so it's enough for him to go through to the next round. It's hectic stuff and desperate for the riders pushing to qualify for the second round of the Kieran. So as he did at the World Champs, Watanabe through Canelon and Shane Perkins, former World Champion, Grzynski, Puerto Zapata, and Speaker miss out. So the riders, that's the first heat for the carcass, Oscar and Philip. So the first three events on the final day of the track here at London. Volokarkas winning that first repechage, the Greek riders into the final, or the second round at least. The final will come as the evening session unfolds, and three medals to be decided tonight on what will be a really action-packed, dramatic evening, a final day on the track. Perkins, Peralta, Gascon, Volokarkas, Watanabe, Philip, and Canelon all through to the second round of the Kieran. And later on, of course, we've got the conclusion of the women's Omnium and, of course, the women's sprint.
Up to the semi-final stage of the women's sprint. Pendleton versus Vogel in the first semi. Mears against Guo Shuang. They met the same stage 4 years ago in Beijing. So much excitement to look forward to. There's the passion of the Greek coach urging Volokarkas on. He got through. A lot of pressure for the riders coming through the repechage. Some got there, some didn't. That's the heat of battle at the Olympic Games. But always an exciting form of racing, the Kieran. So there it is. The morning session on the final day from the Olympic Velodrome complete. We've got the men's Kieran second round and the Omnium, as well as the women's sprint semis and finals to look forward to on behalf of my co-commentator. It's bye for now.